Let's praise the Lord, everyone.
Hallelujah!
We be seated in the presence of the Lord. Truly give honor to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We thank Him for life, health, and strength. We thank Him for His goodness, for His mercy. We thank Him for being in this place of worship one more time.
Yes,
Lord. Lord, we lift up and magnify the name of the Lord. For the Lord is good.
Yes, He is.
Amen. In the name of Jesus Christ, we certainly give Him all honor, all praise.
Thank you, Lord.
And that is due unto His name.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Thank you most of all for this wonderful plan of salvation.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Given unto us, the children of men, that He sent His Son into the world to die for the sins of
thank
us
you, Jesus.
All.
Yeah. Thank you, Lord.
God, that one day I had a mind to repent of my sin.
Yeah.
To go down in water in the wonderful name of Jesus Christ.
Thank you, Lord.
Fill my soul.
Thank you, Lord.
And the person given the Holy Ghost and that with a mighty burning fire.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank God. And thank God for each one of you that are assembled out here tonight.
Amen.
In the name of the Lord. Amen. We greet you in the wonderful name of Jesus Christ. And we greet you in the blessed words of grace and peace.
Grace and peace be multiplied.
In the name of Jesus. We thank God for saying those. Amen. That we miss this weekend in the name of the Lord.
Amen. Truthfully.
Amen. In the name of Jesus Christ, we thank God for the wonderful weekend we did have.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Truly, we thank God for all things. We had a wonderful, wonderful time.
Amen.
Lord. Amen. We thank God for it. And I see travels down the dangerous highways, and we thank God for them. I see the travels back up the dangerous
highway. Amen. Yeah. That's right.
Amen. That we found everything just like we left it.
Thank you, Jesus.
And we thank God for that. For all things, we give thanks. Amen. We thank God for amen. Just being a mighty good God toward us.
Amen.
Amen. In the name of Jesus Christ, we not going to be before you too long. We want to get back into, amen, the issue and the topic that we were dealing with on. The last time I stood before you, the last Tuesday, amen, that I was before you all, amen, we begin to dive into a much needed conversation.
Yes.
Amen, in the name of the Lord. And so we're going to continue on in that same spirit and that same thing.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen, as we deal with it. Amen. And it was wonderful, too, that this topic. Something similar to this topic was even brought up in the midst of
amen,
our fellowship
amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ. And so, amen, we thank the Lord for that. Amen. Just being able to dive into the Word of the Lord and talk about the Word of the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And, we you about to go? In the name of the Lord. All right. Great minds think alike, in the name of the Lord. Amen. So we thank God for just how He just allows things to happen for us to dive into the Word of the Lord. And so, amen, we were dealing with this before we left. We were dealing with it when we got there. Amen. And we're dealing with it when we come back.
Amen.
And so we thank the Lord that we're following after His Word and
living
in His Spirit. But this is the whole truth church.
Yes.
Amen. The Lord Jesus Christ.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. And we are individuals that are endeavoring to seek the truth of God.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord said, when He, the Spirit of truth, has come,
mm-hmm.
He will lead and guide you into what?
All
truth. Amen. And so we are seekers of amen, the truth of God's word.
Amen.
Amen. I don't know about you, but I don't want nobody to lie to me.
Amen.
I want somebody to tell truth.
Amen. Amen. That's
amen.
Right.
Jesus Christ. And so we want to know the truth about all things. Amen. We want to be able to stand amen, before the people proclaiming the truth of God. And we want to be able amen, to stand before the Lord
mm-hmm.
In truth. The word declares, rejoice not in iniquity, but rejoice in the truth.
Amen.
Amen. So we want to be able to rejoice amen, in this wonderful truth in the name of the Lord. Amen. There is but one Lord.
There is but one Lord.
One faith.
One faith.
And one baptism.
One baptism.
One God.
One God.
The Father of you all.
Father of you all.
That are in you all.
That are in you all.
And through you all.
Through you all.
Hear, O Israel.
Hear, O Israel.
The Lord our God is one.
The Lord our God is one.
The Lord our God.
The Lord our God.
Is God alone.
Is God alone.
What's His name?
Jesus.
Jesus. Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Is who he is. And we thank God that we know who he is.
Amen.
In the name of the Lord.
Amen.
We find ourselves tonight in Acts, the fourth chapter. Amen. We're going to find ourselves in Acts, the fourth chapter. Mm-hmm. Amen. And we're going to find ourselves in the 32nd verse. Acts, the fourth chapter. And the 32nd verse. And just to give a brief recap of what we dealt with on the last Tuesday, I stood before you, we dealt with the issue and the topic of giving. And we dealt with it from the aspect of the universal law of sowing and reaping. And so we dealt with sowing and reaping and how that sowing and reaping is a universal law, amen, that God has given to the children of men. Whatever way we look within Scripture, sowing and reaping were hand in hand. Scripture said that which a man soweth, that shall he also reap.
Amen.
And we went through Proverbs and we've seen where individuals, where the scripture said if they sow wickedness, that they're going to reap wrath, and if they sow righteousness, they shall have a sure reward.
Amen.
And so we see that the universal principle of God, that if you sow anything, you will reap it.
Amen.
Yeah, I mean, that's just the universal law of God. Amen. It doesn't matter how much you sow, if you sow, you will reap it. So that's why scripture would tell us when we got to the scripture where it said, if you sow bountifully, you're going to reap bountifully. If you sow sparingly, you're going to reap also sparingly.
Amen.
And so you're going to reap however you sow.
Amen.
All right. So that's just a universal principle of God. And that's what the Lord has given unto all men. Amen. Whatever man sow, he's going to reap it. It doesn't matter what it is, whether it be good, evil, whether it be money, or whether it be righteousness or wickedness, whatever it is that's being sowed, you're going to reap. And then the Lord would even see fit to would allow people, if they don't do it in the right spirit or they're being disobedient to God, he would allow you to sow, and then he will not allow you to reap.
Amen.
Amen.
And in a way to curse you, a way to ensure that you're not blessed, he'll make sure that you do not reap that which you have sown. Amen. But the universal law of God is that whatever you sow, you will reap. All right? And so I just want to bring it into the New Testament just a little bit tonight. I'm teaching on this because it is a wonderful topic that needs to be taught on and needs to be taught, amen, from a biblical standpoint.
Amen.
A biblical standpoint. But not only a biblical standpoint, but it also needs to be taught from a New Testament standpoint.
Amen.
Because I'm learning that we have to begin to narrow things down.
Amen.
Amen. Because you can say that it can be taught from a biblical standpoint, and maybe we'll use Old Testament scripture to try to teach upon it. But it not only needs to be a biblical standpoint, but it also needs to be New Testament. Amen. Standpoints. And so, amen, we're going to get to this topic. It's a wonderful topic. Amen. And I do not think that people in the body of Christ are really ready to receive, amen, in totality, what the word of the Lord says.
Hmm.
Amen. I was talking to a brother, one of our brothers, I was talking to him, amen, the other day, and, he made that statement. He said, brother, I don't know. He said, my question is the church ready, for some stuff? And so, That is the million-dollar question. Is the church ready for a lot of what Scripture truly reveals, amen, within itself? Amen. In the name of the Lord. And so we're going to see something very profound here, amen, in the Scripture. And what the Lord says, what? We're in Acts, the fourth chapter, and we're at the 32nd verse.
And the multitude of them that believed.
And he said, and the multitude of them that believed.
Were of one heart.
Alright, so we're getting back to that oneness again.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Wherever we see within the scripture, the Lord always had his people to be one.
Amen.
Amen. And this is not what we're talking with tonight, but I don't know why the people of God are so divided.
Amen. Amen.
Really gotta take it back. I do know why.
Yep.
Because that's the enemy's job.
That's right.
Is to try to divide the people of
Amen.
God.
Amen.
But God's people who believed were of one heart.
Amen. and one of one soul.
All right, we dealt with one mind and one mouth on Friday night.
Yeah.
In Seaford, Delaware. Wherever you find it, the Lord always has his people being one.
Mm-hmm.
All right, and so in this scripture, he said there are one heart and one what?
Of one soul.
One heart and one soul. Amen. One heart and one soul. One mind, one mouth. One heart, one soul. Everywhere we turn, there's oneness.
Amen.
Amen. And so those that believe were of one heart and one soul. And what happened?
Neither said any of them.
That any of the things that he possessed
was his own.
Amen. Y'all with me?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. The multitude that believed, they were together, and they were of one heart, and they were of one soul. Mm-hmm. And neither did any of them say that the things that they possessed were their own. Mm-hmm. But what happened?
But they had all things in common.
But they had all things common.
Mm-hmm. Amen. Amen.
I'm telling y'all, I don't know if the church is ready, amen, for this type of preaching. And this type of preaching and this type of teaching coming from the Word of God challenges us in ways that we do not like to be challenged.
It's true. Amen.
And this is a fact of the matter. And this is why my preaching is very unpopular. Because it challenges and hits veins that many of us do not want to deal with.
Right.
But when we look in Scripture, it's there.
It's there. Amen.
And we cannot teach and say that we're of the apostles' doctrine and we're of the apostles' faith, that we're of the church of the Lord Jesus Christ, that we follow the example of the apostles and their own church, and then not want to be challenged by the things that they did.
Amen.
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 Praise the name of the Lord. See, when we look in this book, Pastor Sims said something very profound. He said it for years. He said, when I look at the church that is in the Bible, when I look at the church today, I walk away with my head hung down.
Mm.
Because we're not measuring up.
Amen.
And Pastor Sims has been saying that for years.
Amen.
He said, when I look at the church in the scripture, and I look at the church today, I walk away with my head hung down. Because we're not measuring up. But then you get a brother like me that is now trying to pull us up to measure up to them that preceded us.
Amen.
And to say, if they did it, we can do it. Because we follow after the same spirit of faith. If we say we have the same faith of the apostles, then we should be able to move, operate, and do the things that they did. Without hesitation, without restraint, we should be able to do it. Alright? So the Bible said all that believe had one heart, one mind, and the things that they possessed, they did not look at it as their own, but they had all things in common.
Amen.
And what happened?
And with great power, the apostles
gave witness
of the resurrection.
To the resurrection
of the Lord Jesus.
With great power. The apostles gave witness. You cannot preach of the resurrection of Jesus Christ with no power.
Amen.
Amen. When you declare the gospel of Jesus Christ and his resurrection, there should be anointing and power behind it.
Amen. Amen.
Every preacher should be fully persuaded in their belief that Jesus Christ rose from the dead.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. And so with great power, the apostles gave witness to the resurrection of the Lord Jesus.
And great grace
was upon them all.
Thank you, Lord.
And great grace was upon them all. Grace meaning the unmerited favor of God.
Amen.
You do not deserve it. You cannot earn it. You cannot buy it. It is placed upon you by the merit of who he is.
Amen.
And it didn't just say grace was upon them, but great grace was upon them.
What it said.
Great favor was upon them. And God will always give his people grace.
Amen.
I'm telling you, grace can get you places that your degree can't get you.
Amen.
Where your pedigree can't get you. Where your family tree can't get you. Where your marital status, your economic status cannot get you. All you need is the grace of God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
And the grace of God will get you things and places that are unimaginable.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why we pronounce grace and peace upon one another.
Amen.
In order that the grace of God may be upon all of God's people.
Amen.
And great grace was upon them all.
Neither was there any among them.
And neither were there any among them
that lacked.
That lacked.
For as many as were possessors.
And I want y'all to pay attention to this, because it's going to show us the mentality that should be within the body of Christ.
Mm-hmm.
It should be in the body of Christ. He said there was no one among them that lacked.
Amen.
Amen.
Nobody.
Amen.
Lacked anything. In the church.
Amen.
The poor you'll have with you always.
Amen.
Scripture teaches us that. The poor you'll have with you always. And there will always be a need to help somebody.
Amen.
But in the church, it should not be that way.
Amen. Amen.
Not in the church.
Amen.
Because in the church, God has given us a spirit in which we should operate under, which is oneness.
Amen.
Oneness is a powerful and deep thing. It goes beyond knowing the oneness of God and Jesus Christ, knowing the oneness of the baptism in the name of Jesus Christ, one Lord, one faith, one baptism. It goes beyond that.
Amen.
Oneness is deeper than just the things that we quote.
Amen.
It is truly a spirit. And a mindset. And whenever we see in scripture, the people were with one accord, one mind, one mouth, one heart, one soul. Everything was one.
Amen.
And this is what we're missing in the church. And nobody lacked anything because they all had everything in common.
Amen.
All right? I'm about to show y'all. What we in the church do is that when there are believers that fall on hard times, when believers lose their jobs, when believers get in a rut, believers have to go to the government.
No, sir.
Believers have to go to the government.
No, sir.
We have to go to the government. And we got to go to the government and get on food stamps. We got to go to the government to get on government assistance to help pay a light bill. Don't tell me we don't.
That's right.
Because we got saints that have this stuff.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
But the reality is that the church should not have to go to the world for nothing.
Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Don't know the church ready for
Amen.
This.
Amen.
Amen.
Because now it's going to challenge us. The church should never have to go to the world for nothing. God instituted it that way.
Mm-hmm.
That was the purpose of tithing from the beginning.
Amen.
Amen.
If we want to get technical, and if we want to stay biblical, tithing was the welfare system of Israel.
Amen.
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 Tithing was the welfare system of Israel, because those Israelites did not believe in going to nobody outside of them that belonged to their nationality.
Amen.
Hey, y'all say amen. Y'all know them Jews, they still do it today.
Amen. Amen.
They still do it today.
Amen.
They do not put their elders in regular senior citizen homes.
Amen.
You know what they got? They got their own Jewish assisted living places.
Amen.
And they got their own Jewish cooks in there that's going to make their own meals.
Amen.
And no outsiders come in.
Amen.
That's the way God's people has always been.
Amen.
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 The tithe was to take care of the Levitical priesthood, the widows, and the strangers.
Amen. Mm-hmm. Amen.
It was a system that God instituted in order to make sure his people would always be taken care of and they never had to go outside of their nationality to depend on anything or anybody else. So he does not lose that principle. They bring it right over into the New Testament church. That mindset did not leave just because the covenant changed. But the mindset grew greater because now they had something in them that pushed them further to oneness,
amen,
which was the Holy Ghost.
Amen. 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 Amen.
So after they received the Holy Ghost, now their minds say, look, I don't care what I own, it does not belong to me.
Amen.
It doesn't belong to me. It belongs to all the body of believers.
Amen.
So there was no lack among none of them. Why?
For as many as were possessors of land.
All right. It's going to get tight. Many that were possessors of land. Those that were land owners.
Amen.
That had their little couple of acres.
Yeah.
Had their acres of land. That belonged to them, what did they do with them, brother?
Or houses sold them.
If they had land, or if they had houses, they did what?
And brought the prices of the things that were sold.
They sold them.
Amen.
Mm-hmm.
And brought the price of that which they sold.
And laid them down at the apostles' feet.
Brought them and laid it down at the apostles' feet.
Amen.
When you think of this mindset, how many people in the church today, gonna give up anything?
Amen.
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 Amen. Amen.
See, this is why we don't like to deal with stuff like this.
Amen.
Because it's gonna challenge us to another level.
Amen.
Amen.
They did not hesitate. They sold their lands and they sold their houses. And brought the money to the apostles. And what happens?
And distribution was made unto every man.
And distribution
was made unto every man.
Was made to every man.
According as he had need.
According as he had need.
Amen.
So what they looked out among the people, saw individuals that needed certain things. They collected all the money from those that sold their land, sold their houses, and according to needs, they began to give to the people. In order that nobody among the body of believers would have to be struggling.
Amen. Mm-hmm. Amen.
Having to live paycheck to paycheck. Having to do these things. Because they wanted all the believers to be able to freely worship God.
Amen.
You can't freely worship God when you're worrying about bills.
Amen.
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 When you got bills on your mind and you got that pink slip that done came in the mail, and I ain't talking about that pink slip from the job. Because you know, anytime something get ready to get cut off, they send pink notices. You know, you got that car insurance, and the next thing you know, you get the little yellow letter. Then you get a little pink letter letting you know we're about to cut yourself off. So they go through a process. But believers should never be in those types of bonds. Now, we don't want to be foolish now. I want to put the pin here. We do not want to be foolish in the sense to think that everybody that will get something will do wisely with it.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
So you have to have wise men that look out for the needs of the people and know what to give whom and how much to give it to them.
Amen.
So wisdom still must be on display at all times.
Amen.
But there should never be a lack or a need among God's people. Word says what, brother?
And distribution was made unto every man.
And distribution was made to every man.
According as he had need.
According as he had need.
And hosts who by the apostles were surnamed Barnabas.
All right. And Joseph, who was also named Barnabas by the apostles.
Which is being interpreted. The son of consolation.
The son of consolation.
A Levite. And of the country of Cyprus. Having land.
He sold it.
And brought the money. And laid it at the apostles' feet.
Amen.
All right. Now, everybody in the church is following suit with what they're doing. They're all yielding and giving up their stuff to ensure that their brothers and sisters are not lacking anything. But we're about to show you two people, which is a mindset that is heavily in the church today. But we do not expose it because we're not challenging this type of stuff. So it takes a person like me.
Amen.
To look at the word of God and now have to challenge God's people.
Amen.
All right? Now notice what Barnabas did. Notice what all the others did. How they sold their land, sold their houses, and all they could be distributed among the saints. But it's going to be two people that's going to do something. And we're going to see what they do. What the Lord said, what, brother?
But a certain man. Ananias.
With
Sapphira.
And Sapphira.
His wife. Sold the possession.
They sold their possession.
And kept back part of the price.
Alright? Now, traditionally, people would use this scripture to talk about people stealing money.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
They would use this as a justification of people stealing money. Oh, see, they want to be like Ananias and Sapphira, thinking that people are stealing money.
My Lord.
But in fact, Ananias and Sapphira did not steal anything.
No, sir.
They didn't steal anything. But they kept back what belonged to them instead of giving it all to the church.
Amen.
So it was not thievery in the sense that they stole somebody else's stuff, but it was thievery in that they kept back some stuff because they did not want to give up everything.
Amen.
It was selfish.
Amen.
It was selfish. And that spirit is present in the church.
Amen.
We are a bunch of selfish people.
Amen.
But if I could be honest, because I don't mind being honest, that spirit hovers over the minds of black people.
Amen.
That's the truth. That is the truth.
It hovers over the minds of black people. When you go to any other nationality,
that's true.
They know how to help their own.
Yes, they do.
Yes, they do.
Don't tell me they don't. Mexicans will pack up in a house.
Amen.
They will pack up in a house. They will put in and buy one house together.
Amen.
And they will save their money. And you know what they'll do? They'll buy the next family a house.
Amen.
They'll buy the next family a house.
Amen.
They'll buy the next family a house until everybody got houses to live in.
Amen.
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 And then them houses, guess what? Are paid for.
Amen.
Because they all put their money in one basket and help one another out. What's wrong with us Negroes?
Amen.
I'm telling y'all some good stuff today.
Amen.
I'm telling y'all some good stuff.
Amen.
Every other nationality does it. But we are the only ones that rather have our own and struggle with it.
Amen.
That's the truth.
Amen.
You got your little house. I got my little house. You got your little house. And I got my little house. And we all paying the bills and we all struggling.
Amen.
Somebody lose a job, next thing we struggling. And then we don't want nobody to know we struggling. Not gonna come and tell nobody, look, I'm missing behind, I want some payment. Look, I got an eviction notice in the mail. We ain't telling none of that stuff. But we go back home with those issues.
Amen.
Life's about to be cut off. And we ain't telling nobody about it. Because then pride kicks in. Pride kicks in. I don't want nobody to know that I'm struggling. I don't want nobody to know that we're going through anything. And it's a mindset that only penetrates our people. And that's why when it comes to economy, comes to money, we are the lowest class on the totem pole. Because our mentalities.
Amen.
Our mindsets. Then you got people that want to live beyond their means.
Amen. Amen.
No, you can't afford it. But because you want to keep up with everybody else.
That's right.
They got it, I got to have it. Amen. And we are some of the most good looking as broke people. We look good, but we broke. Because with us, it's all about appearances.
Amen.
Amen. It's funny, but it's the reality.
Yeah.
We look good with nice buttoned ups and nice jeans, nice shoes, and broke.
Amen.
But then you got millionaires walking around with regular khakis on, regular little loafers on, regular little cardigans on, and we sit there looking at them and don't know they're millionaires.
Amen.
Amen.
That is the truth.